Alstom Green has been a long partner, long historical partner of power grid and the development of energy system in India. We have been here for 100 years. We have over 100 engineers locally. We are fully trained on our latest smart grid technology. And as a consequence, we are looking forward to supporting the government into moving into the next stage of grid 2.0, which has to be defined in terms of roadmap for in the context of the challenge of India. So here we are talking about developing smart grid with slightly different targets. We are in a country where the grid is behind the need of the consumer, and where the consumer suffers every day from instability of grid systems. So we already do have very large project with power grids onto building large phasor measurement systems for improving quality of the transmission grid. So now the next step is really to roll out technology at the level of the distribution and think how we are going to interconnect down to the consumer. So comes the topic of active load management, quite similar to what is being discussed in Europe, in US on demand response, but which has its own flavor, because here we are in a country where consumers are experiencing blackout on a very regular basis. So the type of service which these people expect from the energy system are quite different from what we have and we see in Europe and US. And what we try to figure out here through that conference and through bilateral exchange with the Indian authorities is what could be the future for the Indian smart grid roadmap. And we think the concept of microgrids is extremely important in delivering this smart future of India. So on the regulatory side, we are following it very carefully. What we miss here with the introduction of renewable is a kind of indication of real-time pricing of energy and giving a price to the private sectors for them to be able to equip with assets to balance instability of renewables. And so there must be evolutions at power grid level, I think, so that the new concept of balancing and auxiliary service market develop. And then once this will be put in place, we'll also see new technologies such as storage starting to come into the picture. And building, I would say, in this large industrial complex, combination of photovoltaic storage and maybe new usage such as electrical vehicles. So here on the regulatory side, we are very convinced that the Electricity Act of 2003 was a very important step to deregulate on the transmission level. Now it needs to be pushed at a newer level for introducing balancing market for renewables, as well as being able to supply very transparent pricing on flexibility to allow private investment for storage or demand responsive loads.